Hi students, today our topic is file inclusions in macroprocessor preprocessor directive. So in the last video and all we have seen about the types of preprocessor directive. So in that we have seen the first type, that is called as macro substitutions. The second one is file inclusion. So file inclusions, it is similar to how you will add header files. No, in the same way only you can add external files also. So similar to header file, you can add external files as a part of your program. So here are some of the examples given. So in that, what is the first statement is hash include syntax.c. So that means that you are having one, see, you have executed one program that is stored in syntax.c. That program concept is required for your another C program. Means you can include that C file as a preprocessor directive before going to execute your next program. So say for example you are going to create one program, that is one file, test1.c. so in that you want to add the syntax.c program, means you can add like this. So hash include syntax.c program. So that means that syntax.c program codings, functions and the logic behind that syntax.c program will be included, will be executed in a test1.c program. Like that you can include external files as a part of your program. Similarly, these are the some of the example, test.c and stat.c. So here also some condition is that if your C program is available in the local disk, the same disk where you have installed your C processor, no, so C compiler, no, so that if it is there, means no need to give the complete path of that C program. Or else if it is if the C program is available in some other directory, means then at that situation what you have to do means you have to give the complete path of that C program. Say for example that C program is available in the local disk D, so D/example/syntax.c means you have to give the complete path of that C program. So that time only that include that syntax.c program will be included, will be recognized. Or else what will happen means it will throw a syntax error that the inclusion of that header file is not, inclusion of that C file is not available. Like that it will show some errors. So you have to be very clear on that. If you want to include one C file, that C file should be copied inside the local disk of your C compiler. So that is a safer and best practices we have to go for, we have to do when you are going to include these files, right? So this is about file inclusion. Then what is the next, third part means compiler controlled directives. So that is the third part of preprocessor directive. So in that what we are going to do means we are going to make some decisions. That means if condition, else conditions, and if not defined, if defined, or end if. Like that we are going to make some decisions. So what are the basic examples of use preprocessor directives we are using here means hash if, has else if, and has end if, and has if not end defined. So like that we are having some preprocessor directives. So the general syntax is given in the left side. So if test is less than or equal to 5, that is test is less than or equal to 5 is my condition. If the condition is true, then statement 1 and statement 2 can be executed, or else part. In the else part, statement 3 and statement 4 will be executed. Then we are in the end of end if. Okay, so first we have to use that if directive. Hash if, the test is a macro substitution. So the test is a macro substitution, that value of test is less than or equal to 5 means that is like a true part. So in the statement 1 and statement 2 will be executed, or else that statement 3 and statement 4 will be executed. So this is the general syntax of compiler controlled. So I have given one example here. What is the example means that is somewhat different. If not defined, that PA is a macro substitution identifier. That if PA is not defined means what we have to do. we have to give some, that is optional. We can give some printf message that PA is not defined, so we are now going to define here. And then if not defined, that condition is true means we have to define the PA. So that statement is added here. So hash define PA 3.14. So that is defined. Or else if it is already defined, means what we can do for that case also, we can give some printf messages. So the in printf PA is already defined in the program. Like that we can give some printf assessment. Then at the end we are going, we have to close the endif. So endif is the directive which should end the if statement. Okay, so this is also possible in the pre-processed directive that comes under the category of compiler controlled directives. So as of now we have studied about the pre-processed directives, some examples and types of pre-processed directives with all individual examples, right? So apart from this pre-processed directives, we have some predefined pre-processed directives that can be easily used in C program. So what are those predefined macros, predefined pre-processed directives means? So here date, time, file, line, std, dc. So these are the some predefined macros available in C language. So let us see one by one. So what is the first one means? Date. Date, it's nothing but it will give the current date in a month, date, year format. So it will give the current date as a character. As a character, it will give the current date with the format of month first, date second, and then years last. So first month and then date, what is the day, date on that month, and then year. In this format, it will give the current date. Then time, exactly, it will give the current date as a character. And then file, in which file we are presently working. So this is also will be retrieved. And then line, in which line as of now present time. So as of now, in which line the cursor is placing. So that is also we can be able to see. Then what, and the when that is stdc is nothing but it defined as one when the compiler compiles in ANSI format. So if the compiler will compiles in ANSI format, means it will be the value of ANSI equal to one. So obviously we are following ANSI standard, there is no differences in that, so it will give one, right? So these are the predefined macros which are available in our C compilers. So we'll see one example with these preprocessor macros. So here I have used some preprocessor directives. So hash include stdio.h is my inclusion statement. Then I have started my main int main. Using the printf statement itself, I have used these kind of preprocessor macros, predefined macros. So file is equal to, because this predefined macros will be returned as strings, so characters. So for that I have used format identifier as percentages. Why I am using format identifier percentages means because these macros will return the value as characters, list of array of characters. So that is what we are using percentage s here. So file is equal to percentage s file. Directly I am using file and date, time, line, stdc. Okay, so these are the predefined macros. Just in the printf statement itself I have used these macros. So we will see the output of this one. So what happens means file equal to test.c. The test.c is my current file. And then date is my June 2, and 2012 is my current date as example I am saying. And then current time is 3:36 and 24. It which line is the current line means 8th line is the current line. Then we are following ANSI standard, so it will give the value as 1. Okay, so these are the predefined macros which are available in C programming. Hope you understand this concept. So as of now we have completed pre-processed directives with all detailed examples. I'll catch you in the next videos with next topic.